Good evening, Exalted High Council, former Grand Swipes in Waiting, fellow Wall Street Kappas, Kappas from Spring Street and Montgomery Street chapters, and worthless neophytes. Hereafter you will speak when spoken to, not described.
Hey everybody, I'm Christopher Green. You're tuning into AMTV, Alternative Media Television. It is, of course, Friday, February 21st, 2014, and I tweeted this out late last night, a new damning article on the oligarchy that is the financial elite that makes up the banksters in places like New York City, around the world, that mock the 99%, mock the middle class while they rape us for everything that we're worth. While they foreclose on our homes and bankrupt our businesses and destroy our lives. In fact, a fantastic investigative journalist that I give much street cred to for his balls and his excellent work in crashing an elite party in 2012 and also choosing to put this out to the public, obviously putting his life at risk, Kevin Roos, who also came out and has just come out with a new book called Young Money: Inside the Hidden World of Wall Street's Post-Crash Recruits. Came out with a story a few days ago titled 1% Jokes and Plutocrats in Drag: What I Saw When I Crashed a Wall Street Secret Society Party, where he basically sneaks in to this elitist gathering in New York City at a fancy hotel where they put members, neophytes of their fraternity, in drag and make them dress up like women and do skits mocking Occupy Wall Street and the bankster bailouts that have cost the American taxpayers and American people trillions, living in their false reality paradigm of elitism, and in the meantime laughing off the fact that they're raping and pillaging America. Again, the bailouts going to billionaires and people like Wilbur Ross, that have so much money, people like Lloyd Blankfein, more money than God, yet they're the ones that get the bailouts while the people suffer, while the people continue to get pounded and raped by these elitists that mock you the groundling, that mock you the voter, a vote that clearly doesn't count in this country. The article is absolutely incredible, is damning, and I am totally surprised there hasn't been more coverage on this. Kappa Beta Phi, a fraternity, a secret society fraternity that has been in existence well since the 1930s and the 1929 financial crash. You remember that? Well, it's coming here to America again. It'll make 2008 look like a church picnic, folks. The people involved in this party, probably talking about world domination here, more money than God. Again, people like Lloyd Blankfein doing God's work. That's a direct quote from Lloyd Blankfein, you know, throughout the 2008 financial crash. Again, mocking the plight of the regular John and Jane, you tuning in, while they rape and pillage America, enforce massive multi-trillion dollar bailouts and a significant amount of debt, an albatross of debt on our backs, which has currently already destroyed America, folks. It's absolutely ended it. More people in this room, more wealth concentrated at this hotel in 2012. They hold this on an annual basis, that if somebody dropped a bomb on the building, Wall Street would literally shut down. That's how many elitists a part of this. Banksters, and members of Wall Street, ranging from the defunct firms Bear Stearns and Lehman Brothers to people like Wilbur Ross, who recently proclaimed that the 1% is being picked on for political reasons. Could you believe that? These elitists, while they mock and do literal skits and sing songs about the bailouts, mocking you, mocking me, make comments like Wilbur Ross has recently done, claiming that the 1% is being picked on for political reasons. There's damning sound evidence that he had recorded on his cell phone while he was in a corner pretending to just, you know, maybe be a server at the party. You can listen to Wilbur Ross's opening speech. You can look at the sickening, disgusting photos of grown men, new members of this elitist fraternity dressed up in drag, wearing makeup, probably engaged in some kind of Eyes Wide Shut orgy in a back room later that evening. You know, some kind of like sex party and just, you know, total satanic devil worship, insanity. Here's a picture of the neophytes, grown men, you know, heavy hitters on Wall Street dressed in drag, laughing, mocking you, mocking Occupy Wall Street, the dirty hippies, mocking the protesters, mocking anyone that has spoken against multi-trillion dollar bailouts while they sit on their perch of elitism, while they talk about globe taking over the world, manipulating foreign exchange markets, like is the recent investigation of JP Morgan Chase, while bankers fly off buildings, you know, dozens and counting, 12 banksters and growing, jumping off buildings in New York City and Hong Kong, in London, because they can no longer live with themselves, because they're either being offed by these criminal elitists, or they're coming to their senses and they're ending their lives because they know of an impending financial crash or something to that regard. Absolutely damning. And you should be absolutely furious. Please share this article virally. Buy Mr. Roos's book, Young Money. And again, he's not paying me to endorse him. I just have high regard for investigative journalists that expose the truth and risk their lives to get this information out to you, the public. Again, we have done several hard-hitting videos on these banker suicides. Please share them all virally. Of course, this comes on the heels. This was just released and broke today. Regulators questioning JP Morgan Chase on foreign exchange manipulation. I had reported on this. This has been ongoing since late 2013, before these mysterious banker deaths and suicides started to occur. Get this article out. The most damning piece that I have seen, the fact that these people can show their faces in our society without being attacked by the 99% is beyond me. I'm Christopher Green. You should be irate. America should be irate. Get this out everywhere.